I've tried many times in the past to make a ZVS flyback driver, and each time my MOSFETs blow after about 30 seconds of use. So when I saw a full-fledged ZVS flyback driver on eBay for 10 bucks, I couldn't refuse. It was shipped from China, which should have been a red flag, but I decided to give it a go anyway. About a week later, it came in less than stellar packaging, but I was surprised by the build quality. All the components seemed to be sturdily soldered in place. Now I'll go over each component and do a price comparison of a home-built driver. So this board costs $10. It sports the usual culprits: two UF4007 diodes, two 12-volt zaners, two 5.2 kilo-ohm resistors, and two 47-ohm resistors. It also has two ferrite core inductors measuring 1.25 inches in diameter and having 30 turns of 20-gauge wire. It has two IRFP260N MOSFETs rated at 200 volts and 50 amps, which are personally my MOSFET of choice when making anything involving a flyback. But it also has two MKPH capacitors rated at 0.3 microfarads, 630 volts AC, 1200 volts DC, and a 50 kHz operating frequency. These are specifically designed for induction heaters, and they make a huge difference when incorporated into the driver's circuit. So it really is less expensive to buy one of these things. But one thing that really costs the most isn't the initial build, it's buying the extra MOSFETs, because you will likely blow up at least four trying to get the darn thing to work. So how does the store-bought driver hold up? I'm going to use this 12-volt, 12-amp-hour battery to power the driver. Here I have a flyback transformer with an 8-turn primary. Some of these drivers are marked as induction heaters and use a center tap, however mine did not. There are four terminal points, one for the input voltage and one for the output pulse. So let's turn it on and look at the sparks. That's pretty good for a Chinese driver. And the best part is that the MOSFETs remain stone cold. My multimeter registered a maximum of 7 amps being drawn at the longest spark length. I'm tempted to push this thing to 24 volts, however, I plan on using this in another Tesla coil video, and I really don't feel like blowing the MOSFETs anytime soon. Well, that's going to do it for this video. I want to say thank you to all the support and criticism on my audio amplifier video. I had no idea that that thing would blow up like it did. And I'll be using the feedback to make better videos in the future. So until next time, see you guys.